One foot in front of the other. That's how we often live our lives, one day at a time.
We're so busy trying to maintain our world, our happiness, our own friends, our time.
How often do we stop and take the time to see, really see, someone else?
Fossil is a big school. There are nearly 2,000 of us.
That means there are nearly 2,000 individual journeys going through our halls every hour, every day.
It's hard to know who another person really is from the brief glimpses we get of each other in the hallways.
Such a small part of who we are can be seen from the outside, and the rest of who we are can be entirely hidden.
What about the people who look different from me, but may see the world the same way I do? And what about the people who see the world in a different way than I do, but those differences could help me grow as a person?
How could my own journey be changed through time spent walking the steps of another? This year's Diversity Day is about taking that time.
What can we discover when we are forced out of our comfort zones, when we walk part of our journey through life together?
This is about taking that first step.
Ten Fossil Ridge students were chosen to be subjects for this year's Diversity Day video to represent a variety of traits, activities, and interests. They were partnered into five pairs and shadowed each other for a whole day to experience what it is like to walk the other person's journey.
Something that changed my life is when my parents got divorced in seventh grade.
Yeah, I guess we're going to see the kid I'm switching with. We're gonna go do the same thing to him. Gracias. All right, see you, Dad. Thanks.
This is Ben.
How's it going, man? An experience that changed my life is when I got diabetes when I was 7 years old. So I'm riding with y'all. And
llegó tarde y estos chicos es un artista famoso. Y él tiene sus propios groupies.
Uy, sí.
Okay, sí. Explícale a la clase por qué están estos tres chiquitos o grandotes aquí.
Es un proyecto para la clase de DLA y yo estoy como una sombra de Ben y Ben me está asombrando a mí. Para mis primeras dos clases y yo voy a sus segundas dos clases.
Ok. ¿Ben?
Sí.
¿Otro Ben? No podemos decir Jorge o Pedro, pero hay Ben, y hay Ben.
Sí.
Hay tres Benes. ¿Ben qué?
Vise.
¿Vise?
Vise.
Ok, ¿tú tienes español?
No.
¿No? ¿Qué clase tienes tú de lengua?
¿Francés?
Oui. Oui, bien, pues mala suerte porque aquí es español. Ah, sí. Ok, tú te vas a sentar junto con él o él se puede sentar donde quiera.
Me tengo que sentar con él.
Ok, no, pues hazlo allá atrás con las sillitas. Y tenemos una pregunta. ¿Y tú, caballero, francés qué? ¿Dos, tres, cuatro, cinco?
Seis, siete.
¡No! ¿Qué nivel de francés?
Trois.
Dos, tres.
¿Qué
dices?
The face.
Paper?
Oh, can I read what it says?
Yeah.
No. No. Oh my gosh. This is brutal already.
What's going on?
They're talking about like some character that's like burned all of his money and went to Alaska.
Is it still about the question?
Yeah, I've been answering the question.
No. Sí. Atención a AP. Jaime, tú tienes que ser el traductor. No está.
Lo siento.
Okay, muy bien, gracias.
Did I say that right?
Yeah. Okay, is it easier to understand Ms. Arroyo or one of the other students that's speaking in the class?
It's probably the same because I'm a native speaker, so I can probably understand what they're saying.
But like, you can understand when the students are like being choppy like that?
Well, yeah, like if they say something bad, it's just like...
completely wrong?
I know whatever they're trying to say.
That's cool. Because I always wondered, like, if I was to go talk to, like, an actual French guy, like, if he'd be able to understand me or not. Everyone that's in this AP Spanish class wants to be there, wants to do their learning. So I feel like in sports, like, the people that want to be there are the people that progress further and help the team more. And the people that don't want to be there and just do it because their parents want to see them there, that they feel like they'll be cool with just being part of the team, aren't really, like, contributing as much as they could be. Hey man. Jaime, do you know what DECA is?
No.
It's a business organization at Fossil. Actually, it's.
Does it Mr. Stevens run it or whatever?
Yeah, Ms. Alcaraz, Mr. Stevens, yeah. Mr. Menifee, they all run it. But this is a class that's like in charge of the like club, the chapter at Fossil.
Cool.
And so we prepare events and business. Fundraise.
Today we're going to do a practice role play. It's everybody's job to print off a role play today and to partner up with someone in this class and have them be the judge and you do the role play, and then you're going to switch. So today everybody has to do a practice role play with another person or team in this class, and you're going to get points for it.
So Josh, Jaime, and I have just been given a role play, a scenario in DECA that we have no clue, nothing about, and we're gonna prepare for it and then give the presentation to what we come up with during this preparation time to the judge.
Hi. Hi, nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you, Ben Vizet.
Rachel Barnes.
Josh Vizet.
Nice to meet you, Rachel Barnes.
Nice to meet you, Rachel.
Appreciate you having us.
Hi, nice to meet you, I'm Rachel sure. Barnes.
Yeah, definitely, thanks for having us.
So we're actually super excited about this new opportunity to promote some new products in our bookstore. Ben and I have actually created a marketing plan, and we'd like to talk to you about some of the new products we'd like to introduce.
We looked over the list you gave us of new items that you might think about introducing.
Breakfast at your house was fun, I thought, because your mom was super like welcoming and she offered me apples that were very good. But I thought it was gonna be more awkward than it was, but it really wasn't.
Send homework that you could have done last night.
So I've heard the softball team is like amazing this year.
Yep, we have state on Friday and Saturday. You have a good shot at winning.
That's awesome.
There's so much flavor to it. What is that? Syrup?
Oh,
Let's, okay, okay.
I didn't sleep very good last night.
Something I've never really done before, like all the kids in that class, they were all people who I wouldn't normally talk to. Like if I see them in the hall, I just kind of walk past them.
Yeah.
But it was really fun to see them kind of interact and like bowl and how your teacher kind of guided them through everything. I haven't taken a PE class ever in high school, so it was fun to kind of play sports I haven't played in a long time because all I've played is baseball, so it was fun to throw football, and even though I wasn't very good at volleyball, it was still fun to play.
I wish I wasn't a senior because I would take a Ridge TV class and just get the basics of it. I would like to learn like what broadcasters do, like to learn, I don't know.
Sports stuff.
Yeah, sports broadcasting. Taken a band class since sixth grade, so I definitely got the extremes on that because they're state champs.
Right now, band is like most of my life because we're practicing 3 days a week, 4 days a week, and then state week's coming up, so we'll practice every day. Like in everyday life, music like it still plays a big role because I listen to it when I do homework, I listen to it when I play sports, I listen to it like everywhere I can pretty much. I was really nervous actually at first because, I mean, it was a girls softball practice and I'm a guy, so I wasn't really ready to just kind of jump into it, but you guys were really nice and you like welcomed me and introduced me.
I'm really passionate about softball because it's my like relaxing point. So I can come off of like a hard day at school and then just go work my butt off to enjoy playing softball and I don't know, just be good at something.
I did not think I was going to be able to hit it, but I actually hit it a lot better than I thought I was going to. But, and then conditioning, oh my gosh, it was, I didn't even do the first part, but then the second part I did, and I'm still sore today.
Hopefully you guys aren't allergic to cats.
My first bite of your mom's chicken quesadillas, it was really good, but it was super hot and I like scorched my mouth. But it was cool actually to see cats sitting like right behind us. I don't have cats in my house. I don't actually have any animals, but whenever we'd look back at the TV, the cat was sitting right on the couch. So that was kind of fun to see. And let's see, what else? Do you have anything?
No, besides that it once again wasn't awkward having you over for dinner, even though I met you that morning.
Yeah, I definitely thought it would be. I was kind of nervous the day before.
Seminary. I got there kind of early and just sat in the room and talked for a little bit, and then once people started filing in, class started and we had our lesson. It was uncomfortable because I'm not used to bringing people to seminary. It's usually like a set group of people that I'm used to being with, and I just felt like the whole time during the lesson I was constantly thinking about like, oh, I hope that this makes sense, or I was more concerned about like the comfort of everyone around me compared to just like paying attention to the lesson.
At seminary, I felt a little awkward. Like, I do go to a youth group, but it's really laid back. And this one, I felt more like, yes, it is laid back, but it's amped up to a higher level because like Mormon versus Christianity is a little different, I feel, and it was just different.
When I took the psych test, I was like a little freaked out at first because I didn't know any of the theories or what they were really talking about. I think the test was about socialization, like, rubs off on people. It was social psychology. The test was about kind of how we read each other's behaviors and what causes those behaviors. Climbing trees, how can much as we were children. Chicken limbs tend to end up bent and broken. Art to me is kind of a place where I can like go and relieve stress or it helps me focus in class. I'll always be doing all of my conversion. Climbing trees, how can much as we were children. I've been doing art for quite a long time. My mom and I, we just kind of bonded over it, and it's never really like left me. I don't always like doodle or anything, but just whenever I'm sad or something, art always helps. I think that lunch was so awkward just because like I don't eat lunch with a giant group of people. I eat it with one person, and she's different. I think it was awkward for me because I just met Micah and I didn't know her friends, and it was a different time of day for lunch for me. It was a different group of people. It just kind of threw me off a little bit. She didn't like having Maroon sit with us because like she couldn't say some of the things that she wanted to say or anything like that. It was a little hard for me on the sense that like I'm kind of a quiet person. I don't tend to just like, if you throw me into an environment where I don't know people, I don't tend to be just like, what's up, guys? I felt like okay with it, but it was uncomfortable for me. Like, I didn't know what to say. I really feel like homework is unnecessary. We study the subject all day in a class period, and then we have to go work on it again after you've already given us, like after the teacher's already given us a sheet to work on during the day. So it's just like, I don't think it's helpful. I think that homework, it can be helpful for like studying purposes, but I think that when it comes down to it, when all the teachers are assigning a ton of homework, it just doesn't, it doesn't accomplish anything. It's just a lot.
Every day, if I don't listen to music, my personality is completely different. Music is basically just like my escape. I sing like 24/7, not 24/7, because you need at least an hour of sleep. But yeah, just every day.
This is the palace. Welcome. I get it done. You know, sleep in as late as possible.
Yep.
You know, get up, take a nice warm shower on a nice cold day.
Yeah.
You know, and then get some fresh clothes on. Oh, there we go. Socks.
Yeah, I'm Mikey McKechnie, and I'm 11th grade junior, and I specialize in freaking living life to the fullest.
Hi, I'm Alicia. I'm a senior, and pretty much, I think I've said that like 5 times this morning. With my free time, I don't have a lot of free time, but when I do, I usually just spend it by myself browsing the internet or like eating food.
That's a model shop.
That's my other home.
That's awesome.
It's like filled with machining equipment, so we have like a CNC mill, we have a lathe, we have...
And you build things?
Yeah, I do. I work with 3D printing stuff, so...
That's sweet. That's gonna be awesome.
More chaotic than usual, more. Honestly.
I couldn't tell you, because, you know, that seemed pretty chill. But again, I'm not in there every day.
I suppose so. Labs are pretty fun. It's not so fun when nothing works, though.
Yeah, that makes sense. That was a little confusing.
Yeah, it's nice to have something
to
do.
You guys problem solved that nice and well.
Yeah, that's pretty well, yeah.
It's definitely, any situation that you can get put in that's different is going to be weird and, like, new and... You gotta get the hang of it, so, you know, today. I mean, I was only in there for like an hour, but still, that was pretty cool, I'd say.
I work as a lab tech intern, so I take apart and put together systems, and I also work half-time in the model shop doing 3D printing.
She's energetic, she likes to have fun, she likes to get her job done. She does really well.
Oh, my experience at HP, that was nuts. That's an intense job. I'm surprised you're like doing that, like rebuilding hardware and stuff. That is,
yeah.
It just seems like a really professional, like exact job. Well, I mean, I'm building sandwiches. She's building computers. You know, I'd say we're pretty spot on. You know, yeah. I say lettuce. She says. Freaking adapter, hardware.
Hard drive.
Freaking hard drive, yeah. Oh, I work at Jersey Mikey Subs. Jersey Mike Sub, to be exact. We are sandwich pioneers, you know, Mike's way. We did it. That's us. Let's see what we got hidden underneath this.
Alrighty.
Hidden underneath
this. I'm ready for food.
Oh, we got some. Oh, look
at. Oh, yeah. Ooh. Ooh. It was going to be something like this, but I was ultimately wrong.
Look at that. Welcome, Sandwich 101. We're here to do things right and make sure you do things right. So let's get started. Look at that. Make sure to keep your hand in a safe position. All right, yeah, go ahead. Right. Now we're gonna wanna get some lettuce, some green. You always need some green in your life, you know? And you're gonna wanna sprinkle that guy on there.
Nice.
Look at Chris, dude. Banana peppers.
Woohoo!
You can never forget your banana peppers. Look at that. That was made by hand. Well, ladies and gentlemen, you saw it from the best, my man. So now the only thing you need to do is make yourself a sandwich. Oh, our class was solid as always.
Are we
enjoyable?
I thought it was interesting because I haven't had an art class since eighth grade-ish. So it was definitely an interesting experience because I used a side of my brain I hardly ever get to use at all. I mean, because I'm sort of like an analytical and logical person, and art is completely just like totally not in
my
realm of what I usually do, especially like creative type stuff, like freehanding and shading. It's really difficult for me. So
a difficult task to learn.
Well, how about we show the camera what you guys drew?
Alrighty. I did a little still life that we've been working on for a while now. Boot and a lamp.
So Mikey made a paper sculpture type thing where he propped paper up with some tape and stuff into different shapes. And then the assignment was to draw that with like shadows and stuff in two-dimensional things. So this is what I got from...
Which is pretty awesome.
My side of it.
Her first time, dude, I just saw it. Well, I mean, I was pretty prepared for it, kinda. I missed the class before, but I was ready for it. I don't know about her as much.
I kind of felt pretty good about that. I don't know. We came across a lot of similar stuff in Knowledge Bowl, so that really helped me out.
I'm not really a big test person.
I was like, oh,
especially
yes,
especially 90 questions. I wasn't ready for that. I thought it was gonna be like a little quiz. Yeah. I need a... maybe study a little bit harder next time before the test, possibly.
I think that class would have been really fun.
Yeah,
had I taken
it's a fun class,
it.
Definitely. Kinda, plants are fun to learn about.
I kind of wish I had taken that. That would have been really nice.
Get real comfortable, and then when you're ready, put weight on your back foot and then just fling it and see what happens.
Let's just...
There you go.
That's
good.
I think I will stick with just plain riding
for now.
Your most insane trick.
Oh, my most insane trick.
Don't kill yourself.
I'm not going to be able to do that.
That's something that looks cool.
Let me do some warm-up lap.
Okay.
Let me get a little warm up here. How was skateboarding for you?
I thought it was actually really fun. I mean, I didn't think that I could ever skateboard or that I would ever skateboard, but yeah, I think I would actually do it just for like the transport.
Doing backflips on that. You come here every day.
Oh, I'm
I can sense it. I can feel it.
Maybe.
The experience was awesome, man. I'm glad I got to teach someone how to skateboard. That's always fun.
Yeah.
That's my boy, Mike.
I'd totally do it again. That was wonderful.
Right. Well, it was good spending that diversity day with you, yo. I'll catch you later, my homie.
Thank you very much.
Good chilling, as always. Take it easy, boys.
I'm really not a morning person.
Yeah.
I hate mornings more than anything. I'm usually really crappy. What does it say?
Do not take another's opinion of you as the truth. Nothing others think or say about you is about you, but rather a reflection of their own reality.
I had the same thing for breakfast this morning. Like literally the same thing.
So good.
It's yeah, so they're good and they're fast.
Thanks, Dad. You too.
Will
do.
Thank you.
Bye, guys.
Bye.
Bye. Thank you.
When he lets us know things late, I don't have that.
I always watch those shows like Criminal Minds and
yeah,
stuff.
Yeah, I know, me too.
And I went through this phase where I was obsessed with Criminal Minds, mm-hmm. and that's all I would watch. When I heard that there's like a psychology class, I wanted to take it. And I thought since I was so interested in it, I could do AP and like go into more depth about it.
Yeah. I do not note take, to be honest. Like if there are terms, I will write them down mostly just because I know I'm gonna be too lazy to write them down later out of the textbook. I find myself drawing a lot in class, and I've noticed that more this year too. It's like holding a stress ball or something. It's an easy way to just sort of work with your hands and keep your mind focused.
No one ever makes me laugh that hard at like 7:30 in the morning, because I'm yeah. not a morning person, and I'm always in a good mood when I'm in his class, unless I'm taking a test, of course.
Yeah.
His tests are extremely hard, and it's really hard. I yeah. struggle.
Yeah.
Now, we're just gonna join in like a group discussion.
I guess people think that I'm organized, and I'm not at all. I like really, really struggle with organization, and I struggle with like keeping myself put together a lot of times and focusing in school, because I like, I don't know, on days when I'm like experiencing depression or things like that, that's definitely a struggle for me to be focused in school and not just like go home and cry. So that's, you know, something that I think people should be aware of.
All right, I put mine as a girl who like works for nothing, because I think a lot of people see me as someone who like her like daddy gives her everything, but when in reality like my parents have raised me to work for everything that I have and be appreciative of everything I have.
It's not what I expected at all. We see this stuff like an advisory and we don't appreciate it, but being like behind the scenes and seeing every single detail that goes into it and how much stress it puts on you guys and like the like compassion that you guys have, it was inspiring. It's pretty French. Pretty much, didn't understand a word.
You actually really impressed me. Like I was expecting you to sit there and just be like taken aback by the entire thing, but I saw you during that quiz and you were following along with the lines of the song, and the things that you wrote down on that quiz sheet were so funny. I didn't realize how much I loved languages until I started to become more fluent in French.
Learning a language mm-hmm. is like one of the coolest things you can do, yeah. because to be able to be bilingual and travel around the world and be able to like understand what other people are saying yeah. and their culture is so cool. Mm-hmm. If I could take language without the tests and the homework, I would be yeah. all about it. I would take all the languages I could. So Tuesdays and Thursdays I go to Huntington mm-hmm. and I have 15 minutes to get there. Yeah. So I eat as I drive, mm-hmm. and then I usually have like 5 minutes to spare once I get there, mm-hmm. and I just finish eating in my car.
I really liked the guy who's tutoring you. He was pretty fun.
And honestly, you're probably, I mean, I've been doing this job for almost a year now, and I think you're the only person who's been actually excited and interested about making passage.
I don't know, I think that in general, I felt like it was maybe a little bit of overkill. I don't know, I mean, I guess it's whatever helps people. You know, people are all different.
Yeah, I think mainly what I'm using Huntington for right now is I have like a really hard time with test taking. So right now it's helping me like timing issues, and it's almost more of a comfort thing knowing that when I get the test, I know the information and there's like, I've been preparing for it.
Okay, I get so many questions on this. It is not a tattoo, it's Sharpie. I mostly just write thoughts. I find that to be a way to like get all of that out and communicate with myself.
I'm that way, but in a different way. I'm that way with like, because I'm so like OCD. Mm-hmm. When I'm stressed out about something, I have to write it down, because mm-hmm. I have so many thoughts going on in my head, and then I'm worried about forgetting those like things I have to do, and I have to write every single thing down. Yeah. And once I do, it's like a big weight's been lifted off my shoulders.
Yeah, he's Superman's favorite guy.
Wait, we're going back to Fossil.
I'm super glad you're here. This is Veg Alliance, and we teach people about the benefits of veganism.
For me, because my schedule's so busy and I'm constantly around people, when I have time off, I like being home because I crank out my homework better when I'm by myself. And I would rather be at home, like on the couch reading a book with the fireplace on. So the Bean Cycle is like a very significant extension of my soul, I would say. I am way, way better at working when I have like a bunch of people around me. Like even if they don't know me, it kind of like makes me feel like I have to work to make them think highly of me. I think that at the very beginning of the class when you guys were freestyling, I was amazed, and I think I actually started tearing up a little bit. I'm sure that we got plenty of this on camera. I started like, I'm getting like misty eyed just thinking about it. It was so beautiful, like wow. And I think that towards the end of class, I was tearing up just because it was so beautiful. It was making me realize I've kind of had this void in my life recently where I haven't been really passionate about something. You know, like I can see in every single one of you how intensely passionate you are about this and like how much you put your life into it. I don't have one focus point, you know, like you guys do with dance. And that was just making me like really emotional, I think. It was like a really intense experience. It was beautiful.
Yeah. Thank you.
Do you look for in a friend?
I have to be nice to everyone, not just me.
There's somebody who will be willing to go out of their way to like pick me up on days I'm down.
No, I look for someone that like teaches me things, I think. You know, like I want to find someone who has different qualities than myself.
Share three things on your bucket list.
To travel to every single continent.
Scuba dive in the ocean.
Want to go to like a World Cup game?
Oh, that'd be sweet.
Talk about one of your long-term goals.
Like going to college, graduating from college. Be the first one in my family to do that.
That's awesome.
To get my master's in engineering. I don't know what kind of engineering yet, really.
How often do you get to actually live someone else's life?
Taking a step in someone else's shoes. I didn't walk very far, but I got a little sneak peek.
Talk about one core value or belief you have.
No matter what you're doing, you should do it like 100%. Even if you don't like what you're doing, you need to give all your effort. a secret handshake.
I honestly think it allows me to open up to more people and just be willing to become friends with them because they'll be outgoing like you are and easy to talk to.
This did change my life, actually. I mean, shadowing you, like, I definitely had, you know, stereotypes in mind when I met you, and you broke, like, all of them. I mean, you're a really amazing person, and I think that that kind of will make me think about the way that I look at everyone else.
It's amazing what we can learn, feel, and love when we take the time. It's in all of us to make that happen, to take the time while on our own journey to share footsteps with each other. We're not all the same, and sometimes we're not all that different. It's up to us to create the connections that bring us together to light our journey. We're all going to go our separate ways. It's these moments we make that matter.
Should be.